Why is weight loss such a problem as we get older, heading into perimenopause and menopause? Well, there's a couple factors at play. Number one, cortisol. The more stressed out you are, the less you're going to be able to lose weight. I don't know how many times I have to hammer this into ladies. It's not that you need another diet. It's not that you need another workout program. It's not that you got the wrong protein powder. It's not that. You need to work on your stress. I can tell you from personal experience, the more times that I have been stressed in life, the harder it is to maintain my weight. I start gaining in the abdomen. I start gaining in the waist. It is a problem. It is something that you need to accept. There's no miracle when it comes to reducing your stress. You have to do it on your own. And this could be the number one factor interfering with your ability to lose weight. The second one is insulin. What is going on with your blood sugar? Well, guess what? When your blood sugar goes up, you need more insulin to grab that glucose and bring it into the cells for energy. If it can't do that, well, that extra glucose is going to sit around and get stored as fat. So if you have some insulin resistance issues, it's going to be even harder to lose weight. You might also be noticing that you can't remember things because higher insulin causes some troubles in that department. So what do you want to do? You want to test your saliva cortisol. You want to know where that is at. You want to know morning. You want to know before lunch, before dinner, before bed. What does that cortisol level look like? You also want to know what is going on with insulin. How high is it? Are you insulin resistant? Is it low? You can test that through regular labs. You could do it through Quest. You could do it through LabCorp, blood test, fasting. Look for that insulin. Next thing, what is going on with your hormone balance? A lot of ladies will come to my office and go, "Hey, doc, I just need some estrogen and progesterone. I'm gonna lose weight." Right? No. Doesn't work that way. I don't know how many people I've put on bioidentical hormones and they were hoping for weight loss because, you know, us ladies, that's what happens. That's what's in the back of our minds, right? When am I going to lose weight? I just want to get just a little thinner, right? Those bioidentical hormones are helpful, but if the cortisol isn't checked, if it's not checked, you're not going to lose weight. So you got to be thinking about that. Next thing, dysbiosis. What is going on in that gut of yours? These are the four things that you need in check to be able to get that weight loss going. You can't just use one without the other. You need to know what is going on between all of these different factors. So keeping in mind, is your gut okay? Did you test it? Well, how do you do this? There's Excella internal fitness testing to show you what's going on with the gut balance. How do you do the saliva cortisol? You spit in tubes, ZRT lab. That's how you get that testing. How do you know about insulin? Ask your doctor for an insulin resistance score. That way you will know what is happening in that department. What do you do about your hormones? You can do a Dutch test, which is a dried urine test to look at the metabolites, or you can look at your hormones in your blood. If you're still getting your period, you want to look at the second half of your cycle between day 19 and 26. If you aren't getting your period, it doesn't matter. You can get those hormones tested whenever. But you do want to know, are you deficient? What's going on? Because estrogen has a lot of factors in helping you with maintaining your weight. Progesterone does as well. The more cortisol you have floating around in your system, the lower your progesterone will be. So these are all important factors in the conundrum as to why are you not losing weight or why are you struggling to maintain a healthy weight. So get those checked versus jumping to the next diet or weight loss plan or fitness instructor. This isn't gonna help you. You have to put your hormones in check first to be able to get anywhere. And number one, if you forget nothing from this chat today, cortisol, cortisol, cortisol. It is going to be the number one thing impeding your success with weight loss. I'm Dr. Janine Krause. Thanks for watching.